our neck. Now, if that same man that put yokes of iron upon our neck, the same man that raped our mothers, raped our women, that's the same man that taught you another Jesus. Would you believe in what that man has to say? The same man that raped your foremothers and raped your forefathers, would you trust him enough to teach you about the word of God?
Bring it out.
So that goes my question again. That's why I asked y'all, where did this image come from? Because this, prior to the 1400s, this image did not exist. This is a man named Caesar Borgia, okay? You can see the sketches at the bottom, okay? He hired Leonardo da Vinci to paint the sketches of this man right here and make him into the image of Christ. And this image is pushed throughout the entire world.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? They are not preaching the true image of Christ, which is the picture right there. They're preaching this image of Christ. You know what I'm saying? So that's how you know. So is it safe to say that you have been lied to? Can you say that somebody actually lied to you? My sister, can you actually say that somebody actually lied to you? You don't think so? So, today in church, they teach you this image of Christ. And we just ran over, we're going to go into it more about the true image of Christ. But the same man that preached to us another Jesus is the same man that we got to get our food from, our water from, and everything that we may need to survive. Okay? So now, that's how we know that we are destroyed people. Not physically destroyed, because we're still walking, breathing, conversing today.
Right.
But we are spiritually and mentally destroyed, divided into different religions, divided into different nationalities. Okay? That's why we think, let me get Jeremiah 50 and 33. That's why we think that Puerto Ricans and blacks are different people. That's why we think that Haitians and Dominicans are different people. But we are the same people. We have the same exact enemy.
Right.
Because the same way so-called blacks had yokes of iron upon their neck is the same way the so-called Native American Indians and Hispanics had yokes of iron upon their neck.
That's right.
And today, many of our people celebrate Thanksgiving. But what we're celebrating is the bloodshed and slaughter of millions and billions of Native American Indians.
Bring it up!
You know what I'm saying? And many of our people foolishly believe that that's the day that we have family time. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But read this real quick. I want to show you something.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 50 and verse 33.
Bring it out.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah.
So when it says the children of Israel, it's making reference to the tribes that you see. You see Ephraim, Manasseh, Simeon, all those tribes down. That's referring to the children of Israel, which would make up the northern kingdom Israelites today, the so-called Native Americans and Hispanics today.
Right.
So it said the children of who?
The children of Israel and the children of Judah.
So the children of Judah will be referred to as the southern kingdom of Israel, which goes into Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, which would be the so-called African Americans, the so-called Jamaicans, and the so-called Haitians today.
Yes.
Now what happened to them?
Were oppressed together.
We're oppressed together, meaning what? That we have the same enemy. The same atrocities that happened to the so-called blacks, it actually happened to the so-called Hispanics first.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We were the first ones in slavery when Christopher Columbus came over here. You know what I'm saying? In the year 1492, that's when he did his voyage with his three ships, okay? The Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria. You ever heard of that in history school? You know, they teach you that, and they teach you that Christopher Columbus discovered America. But we're going to prove to you that that's not even true. All right? Like, get ready for second Esdras. I want to prove to y'all that that's not even true. So far, do y'all have any questions based on what we went over so far? Do you have any questions? We're just getting an understanding. What about you? What about you? Now, yeah? So, mind you, if y'all have any questions, feel free to ask. That's what we're here for. You know what I'm saying? We are out here. Yes, sir, go ahead. Huh? Okay, now, let me get Isaiah 29 and 13. So now, you got to think about it. Why didn't they tell us that, right? Exactly. So now, the same, because guess what? Do you think a slave master is going to tell his slaves the power that he has? Why wouldn't a slave master tell his slaves the power that he has? Why wouldn't he? Ah, they'll be ahead of him, right? Real quick, before you go there, let me get Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 12. Say that one more time. Why would not the slave master want to tell his slaves the power they have? Say it on the mic.
They'll be ahead of him.
Because they'll be ahead of him, right? So now that means that the slaves will be ahead of him, right? The slave master, right?
Right.
So now I want to show you that that's the way it was supposed to be from the beginning.
Yep. Bring it out.
Right. Listen to this.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, and verse 12. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, to the heaven to give the rain unto thy land.
Real quick, start at verse 1. I'm sorry, I got ahead of myself. Start at verse 1, because what now? We're going over the blessings and the curses. So right now, what we're about to read is the results if we kept the commandments of God. So start at verse 1.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, and verse 1.
Bring it out.
And this shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So it said, it shall come to pass if we would hearken. Another word for hearken is listen diligently to the voice of God, which is the Bible. Go ahead.
To observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Is the so-called black and Hispanic man on high today?
Bring it out.
Is he set on high today? Is he looked at as somebody that's important today? Now, I'm not talking about our sports entertainers, and even them, because even the same way, like LeBron James and many of our celebrities, at the end of the day, they are still considered the N-word in the eyes of the white man.
Right.
Okay? So it said, if we kept the commandments of God, because I'm going back to your point, the slave master is not going to tell his slave how much power that he really has.
Right.
Because he fears of the slave rising above him.
Right.
Now I'm going to show you that that is a blessing if we kept the commandments of God.
Yes.
Verse 12.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 12. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure,
and
the heaven to give the rain unto thy land in his season.
Read.
And to bless all the work of thy hand.
Ahead.
And thou shalt live unto many nations. And the work of thy and to bless all the work of thy hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations.
So this is one of the blessings that we shall lend unto many nations. I want to ask you today, does a so-called white man go to a black man for a loan? Or is it the other way around? Does a so-called Chinese or Japanese man go to a black man for a scholarship, to get a scholarship? Or is it the other way around? We got to go to them, right? Goes back to the curse that we read in the want of all things. So now, we have to go, they have to, read that again.
And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow.
Read on.
And the Lord shall make thee the head, and not the tail.
The Lord shall make us the head, and not the tail.
Bring it out.
That's what you had just said on how the slave master would not tell his slaves the power that he has because he fears of that slave getting above him. But we just read the blessing. If we kept the commandments, we are going to be the head, and those other nations are going to be the tail. We don't... Okay, so now I want to ask y'all something. So that's the blessing, and the curse will be the other way around. Now I want to ask y'all, is there anything that y'all deal with, like something like whether it be emotional or whether it be anything that may cause you to be depressed? Is there anything that y'all deal with? What about you, sis? Huh? Anxiety. So that means you get worried, right? Sometimes you get worried. Let me ask you, like, what are some of the things that worries you? What are some of the things that worries you? You don't get your assignment done? What about you? Studying, not having. So pretty much like dealing with school and stuff like that worries y'all? Okay, now, let me get Sirach real quick. Because what we have to focus on is that when we keep the commandments of the Lord and we obey what he tells us to do, God tells us that He is going to be our protector. So anything that we put our hands to do, the Most High God is going to be right beside us as long as we are abiding in His commandments. You know what I'm saying? There's no fear that we should have if we are keeping the laws of God. Because guess what? One of the blessings, you know, that the next teacher will go over, one of the blessings that we have is when we stand up as a mighty nation, the other nations are going to fear us.
Right.
Today, they don't fear the black man.
Right.
They don't fear the so-called Hispanic man today. Because the so-called black man is killing one another. The so-called Hispanic man is killing one another. So the so-called white man stands back and says, you know what? I'm going to just let them kill themselves. All the white man got to do is just stand on the sidelines.
Daniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.